Hello, my name is Angel Espinoza, and for the next short while we'll be exploring Navisworks 2014. Navisworks has very many useful capabilities, and we'll begin by looking at the ability to open up various file formats. So if we were to choose to open a file, we can see then that the drop-down contains quite a number of file formats. So let's explore a few of these. As we look, 3D Studio is amongst them. CATIA, MicroStation DGN, and others, DWF, Faro, Inventor Files, Leica, ProEngineer, SketchUp, SolidWorks, STEP, and others. As it turns out, there's over 60 different file formats that can be utilized. New to Navisworks 2014 is the ability to bring in Autodesk Recap Files, which is a new application recently introduced. I will go ahead and open up an existing file. And we see the speed at which this file is opened. As it turns out, another of the very nice capabilities of Navisworks is the ability to aggregate very large data sets. So if we were to look at the scene statistics, we'll find that this particular model contains over 3 million objects. Even so, the file opened very quickly. Now, once we have a model open, one of the very important things we'll need to do, is to navigate in a 3D environment. So Navisworks contains some of the typical interfaces that people are accustomed to from Autodesk. Items like the view cube, where we can simply click on certain parts and orientations, and have the file quickly reorient itself. Additionally, there is the interface that is referred to as the steering wheel, or other commands that people are quite commonly familiar with, things such as pan, zoom, orbit, and then a little bit later we'll see the ability to both fly and walk. Once we maneuver to within our environment, it may be appropriate to determine what it is that we're looking at. So we'll begin on the Home tab by choosing Select and touching various items. So as I touch this and I look at the selection tree, I'll pin this open, we'll see that I've touched a transformer capacitor. There's another one there. Now, depending upon the authoring application, we could also find properties that would be available on the Properties tab. Similarly, as we maneuver around, it may be necessary to have a more thorough understanding of what it is we're selecting. So in this case, as I select one item, we see that it has a particular name. We can then use the Find Items window to tell Navisworks to search for all items with similar names. So in this case, I'll tell it to find an item whose name contains the information we had just seen, which was, I'll just simply type in INP. Then we can see that we can specify whether we need to match the case or something along those lines, and we'll tell it to find all. At that point, all items that are similarly named will be selected or highlighted in the model. Once we have all of these particular items selected, it may be useful to come over to the Sets tab, right-click and choose to save that selection, and giving that a name, all INPs. We will find that creating sets is a very useful capability later in the demonstration. Now, once we've created certain sets, it's also possible to very quickly and easily use the Autodesk rendering capability, which is new to 2014, replacing the old presenter capability. And by selecting certain items and then applying certain materials to them, such as in this case, anodized red. On highlighting them, we see that they've all received that particular material. So creating sets can certainly help us in both the assignment of materials and other ways, which we'll see in just a moment. Now, as we maneuver around, it may be appropriate for us then to choose a particular point of view or viewpoint that is useful for others to find. So here, going to the viewpoints window, I'll right-click, save the viewpoint, and we'll call this close-up of INP. We can create folders within this area and likewise very quickly jump to other views. Now in this case, the materials might be as originally defined, but after a little bit of material assignment, we can have an environment where all of our materials are assigned and our viewpoints can either contain material assignments or no material assignments. So in this case, we'll see a close-up with materials and then another close-up with slightly different materials where all of the items that we selected earlier are given a clear presentation. It is also possible to select items. In this case, I'll go back to these here and choose items to hide or to unhide. So once we've saved certain viewpoints, we can just simply jump between them to get to where we wish. One of the next capabilities, as I mentioned earlier, is the ability to walk. So not only can we initiate a walk and then maneuver, changing the direction within which we walk, we can also, on the animation tab, begin a recording, which will then capture our movements. We can then begin to move this way, begin to move this way. We can even move backwards if we choose. At any point, we can stop that. The animations will then be found on the saved viewpoints. Coming back to it, I can tell it to play. Now the interesting thing about these animations is at any point, these are simply keyframes, I can pause animation and take off or maneuver in an entirely different direction. Coming back to it, we can tell it to play. It'll play from beginning to end. Now it may be necessary for us to eventually export these animations for other people to have access to them, and we can certainly do so. There are various formats within which we can export those to. Additionally, it may be necessary for us as we maneuver to have an understanding of certain things. So maybe knowing that the concrete poles are a particular height, so as I select one, we'll see that we're told that these are 55 foot high concrete poles. On the review tab, we can do a measure to verify from the top of the pole to the concrete pedestal, 55 feet. Additionally, as we maneuver around, it may be that we find something that we're not clear about or need further explanation. Just zooming in, we can see that these items appear to be unaligned. We'll save a viewpoint. And then add in either a cloud or a comment. Now, red lines are viewpoint specific, so as soon as we change our orientation, the particular comments went away. But going back to the viewpoint, we can see them present. Now, one of the very important capabilities is the ability to create and use a timeline for construction sequencing. Within the timeliner, we can set up a series of tasks which are linked to the objects. These objects can also be linked to a calendar. There are various ways to configure this. One, under the data sources, we can see that we can add in either comma delimited files, Microsoft project information, Primavera of various file versions, can all be brought in to create the tasks. Also, once the tasks are in place, it's possible to push these tasks to the sets to populate sets more easily. It's also possible, once we have sets, to push them straight into the tasks. With the auto add tasks, we can say create a task for every set. All of our sets would be populated along with a preliminary date and time. And we'll notice that the attach of the objects are already present. At this point, we can go to the simulate tab within this window and begin the simulation. Now, what we'll notice is that items may be shaded with green. These are as they're being constructed. Once they're constructed, they will become fully solid. Also possible would be the ability to show deconstruction or removals. So we're seeing the project being built as it would be per a construction schedule. Now, once the timeline is complete, we can also come in and move the timeline slider to different points in the project construction sequence or schedule to see and have an understanding of where and when certain things will be built. So Timeliner allows for the organization of construction information. One of the most important capabilities of Navisworks Manage is the ability to do clash detection. I already have 3 tests available, so we can see the results of these. 1, supports versus wiring. On the selection tab, we can specify various ways of selection A versus selection B. So here I'm comparing all structures against the power lines. So as we run the test, we're checking a hard clash with 0 clearance. In the results, there was no clashes. Our second test will be supports against transformers. Here, as we run the test, we find that there were a series of clashes. We can review the clashes. Allow me to move the window a little touch. Jumping to the different clashes to have an understanding of where these are. This is exactly earlier where we've seen that potentially these were unaligned. So once we have results, we can also generate reports. These reports can be of various formats, as you can see here, HTML, and viewpoints, etc. These can then be published to be shared with appropriate stakeholders. Now it's also possible to check for clearances. On the selection tab here, we'll be checking to make sure when and where the wires come within perhaps 1 foot of our structures. And then we can verify whether these clearances of 1 foot are appropriate or not. So in conclusion, Navisworks gives us many very useful abilities to understand our project.